I'm about to launch from the shadows like a lion on the grind coming at you. I'm a menace for the vengeance, so relentless. Hope you ready, cause I'm here to battle. Keeping me awake till the late night. Thinking about a wrong, I'ma make right. When you see me, better take flight. Venom in my veins, and I'm all out of play nice. And it's bye-bye gone to the bygones. Ain't no turning back when the fight's on. When you see the white in my eyes, better run, better hide. No surviving what I'm on.
I ain't here to play around. If I were you, I would run right now. Make your feet bang, bang on the ground. Cause I'ma hunt you down, down, down. I'ma hunt you down. I'ma hunt you down, down, down. Cause I'ma hunt you down. I'ma hunt you down.
What is up, guys? Dashing here for episode number 5 of Octane. We are, of course, fresh off the heels of Point Break and now officially on the road to Ascendance 10. Can you feel it in the air? I certainly can in my pants. And we are jumping straight into the action as always. Getting things started here tonight with some six-man tag team action. Bob Luger leading Xander Slate and Josh Wolf to the ring as Click gets set to battle the Justice Family. And what a show we have in store, guys. A hell of a main event. I cannot wait for the potential to be an absolute show stealer. Match of the year candidate as Troy Colt will go one-on-one with CMV Global Champion Blake Virtue, first time ever here in CMV. Both men having a very good night at Point Break, but so did Click, of course, finally bringing this war to an end that has been waged for months on end, defeating Timotheus and the team in that Anything Goes Tornado Tag Team matchup. Bob Luger, of course, feeling real good about himself after tapping out the Ted to win that match. And now Click can finally look on to the future. Ascendance 10 awaiting them. Bob saying that by the time Ascendance 10 comes around, Click will be back on top where they belong, running Octane. Things will be as they should be, but Click, of course, going up against the Justice Family here tonight, who also had a very good night at Point Break. Bloody Justice finally winning his first singles championship. Of course, it was via nefarious means, but no doubt about it, the CM Universe has been rejoicing after years and years. Bloody Justice finally is a champion. And the Justice Family, I'll tell you what, they have been partying hard this past week in the Bloody Forest. But now it's time to get down to business. Both of these teams wanting to pick up momentum en route to the show of shows. Bloody Justice wanting to share his success with the rest of his family. Not coming out with his Anarchy Championship here tonight. Keeping it in the back. He knows that Fidel De La Rosa made a promise, or better yet, a vow after what transpired at Point Break, that not only would Amare Rivers get his comeuppance, but Bloody Justice would as well. So the leader of the Justice Family just wanting to play it safe here tonight. He's got eyes in the back of his head. Doesn't want Fidel De La Rosa trying anything. Coming out here trying to take back that Anarchy Championship. Smart move, if you ask me. After all the work Bloody Justice has put in over these years to finally win a singles championship, not going to let anything bring a stop to this celebration. Now, De La Rosa is in the building here tonight. He's going to be a part of the King of the Hill qualifier a little bit later on. But now here comes Jared Leon and Matthew Justice. Now, what the hell is this? Another contraption from the Bloody Forest? Seems like everything that comes out of the Bloody Forest, man, just coated in a thick layer of rust. What the hell is this, though? Straight out of the wasteland. BJ's brother-in-law, Jared Leon, and of course his younger brother, Matthew Justice, looking for their own taste success after seeing Bloody Justice get the job done at Point Break. Keep me away from that thing, man. I did not get my tetanus shot. So here we go. Six-man tag team action, my friends, to get things started. Bob Luger gonna test the waters with Bloody Justice. Long history into the Bloody Forest. Not something the Work Ethic Titan likes to often talk about. Great start by the CMV Anarchy champion. Couple of elbows in the midsection, though. Gonna break Bob Luger out of that hold. Right into a belly-to-belly suplex. Stop, though, at the very last second by Bloody Justice. Yes, indeed, my friends. We had our first King of the Hill qualifier in this past episode of Shockwave. Robert Cross victorious, taking the first of eight spots at Absolution in 4 weeks' time. The King of the Hill match returns, and one man will go on to headline Ascendance 10 for a shot at any championship they desire. Our second qualifier going down right here tonight. Eight man over the top rope battle royale. Cheeky jab by Bloody Justice gets right back out of the ring. Justice certainly no qualms with what happened at Point Break, capturing the Anarchy Championship, but only after an interference by Amare Rivers. Beating the hell out of Fidel De La Rosa allowed Bloody Justice to capitalize. Like I said, Bloody Justice working so hard for so long, he's not going to sneeze at what transpired. But now he's got a lot to prove as Anarchy Champion. In comes Xander Slate with a sit-out. Alabama Slamma. These two also have a very long history with one another. In fact, only a couple of years ago, they faced each other for the CMB Anarchy Championship when Xander Slate was the reigning champion. Big time splash by the OG Dirty Heel, looking to bring this match to an end very early on. Not to be. Asking his big bro to make the tag instead. A face scrub and then an elbow drop to the back of the head, and Xander Slate doing what he does best. Slowing things down, having himself a good time. What a double axe handle. Here's a tag to Josh Wolf. Stiff kick to the middle of the back. Not too sure what Slate's doing here. Having some trouble getting out of the ring. He's got to be careful. He's going to be disqualified here. That was a very close call. Belly to belly. Chest bump. No sportsmanship to be had here, though, as Josh Wolf sends BJ into the corner. These two also have a history competing over the global championship only a couple of seasons ago. In fact, I believe it was a triple threat match between these two and Bob Luger. That's where Josh Wolf captured the CMV global championship. Tag made to Xander Slate. Hot tag also made to Jared Leon. Here comes the big brute of the Justice family. Carried into the corner, dropped on the top rope. Full mount by Leon. Hammer fists trying to break through Slate's defenses. Nasty elbows. Nothing Slate can do here but try to defend himself. But Jared Leon on top of him like a monkey on a cupcake. Going after that other eye with those closed fists. Slate in a world of hurt right now. No sign of stopping anytime soon. Tag made now to the younger Justice brother. rolling up on Xander Slight. Goes for a high kick, ducks it, does the show right into a standing cutter. Beautifully done, if I do say so myself, and I do. Follows it up with a nasty knee to the face. Outlaw stomps the chest, one after the other. Trying to suffocate Matthew Justice, the Snake Lord, fires off an elbow to the jaw. The rest of the Justice family gonna try to follow up on the example set by Bloody Justice at Point Break. He did say at the start of this season he would lead the Justice family to fortune. So far, so good as we get a stalling vertical suplex from the OG Dirty Heel. And some more stomps. Xander Slate firmly in control here. Slap to the chest, gonna leave a big red mark, I'm sure. Matthew Justice quickly sending Slate into the corner of the Justice family, not where he wants to be. Tag made to Bloody Justice. Look at this teamwork. Oh, man! And hooks the leg as Bloody Justice won. Broken up, however, by Bob Luger. I don't think I've ever seen anything like that. Came rolling off BJ's shoulders into a sort of senton. There comes Jared Leon. Frequent tags between the Justice family members. Gonna bite the hand now. What's wrong with a little mid-match snack anyway? Another pinfall attempt. Josh Wolf worried for his brother. Xander Slate able to kick out on his own, though, as Leon tries to keep up the attack at the Dragon Skinner. Just like that, Xander Slate sees his opening, takes his shot. Vintage Slate with the Samoan drop. Leon just gets right back up, though. Slate says, not so fast. Ripcord form smash and a tag to Josh Wolf. The jaw into the collar and elbow, knee to the midsection though, gonna back Wolf up. Leon pouncing on him, single knee backbreaker, and again, that just throwing him off to the side like a rag doll. Matthew Justice in off the tag. Josh Wolf surrounded right now. Not having a good time at all. Power slam by Leon, feeding Josh Wolf to Matthew Justice. Beautiful running knee into an inverted Frankensteiner. That is what I like to see. Incredible athleticism by Josh Wolf and a tag to Bob Luger. Somehow Matthew Justice already back up on his feet. Luger gonna take care of that real fast though with a snap vertical suplex. And look at Click working like a well-oiled machine. Josh Wolf back in off the tag and instantaneously goes for that vintage DDT of his off the kneeling position. Will that be enough? Very well could be. One, but not even. Barely a two count. However, Josh Wolf's not finished. V2 incoming, counters it though. Into a German suplex. Very quick thinking by Matthew Justice. Oh, the poison mist! The poison mist and then the punt kick! Venom in the eyes! Venom in the eyes! Wolf is reeling! Matthew Justice gonna try to finish him off! With the cutter, which we're not gonna see! Great camera work! Hooks the leg, one! Two! Broken up by Slate though. Just pissed off, gonna make Slate pay with the Whirly Bird head scissors. Josh Wolf still not in good shape. Tag made to Jared Leon. As we see Bloody Justice at ringside, making Bob Luger as dizzy as can be. Kick to the midsection by Wolf. Knee to the face. Leon taking it like an absolute monster. Body block using his weight to mow down Wolf here. And the choke, the two-handed choke, has Wolf elevated in the air. Nowhere to go. Luger trying to save him, but failing. As Bloody Justice sends him into the corner. Wolf did not tap, but he might be put to sleep here. No, 2.999. Leon still is not finished, man, and John Wolf is not having a fun night here on Octane. Episode number 5, Pedigree! Pedigree! 1, 2, no! Can you believe it, Josh Wolf, enduring all this punishment? And now Leon's almost confused. He doesn't know how to proceed here. He really thought that was going to be enough to get the job done. Tag to Matthew Justice. Wolf standing firm. Really should make a tag if you ask me. Fighting off Bloody Justice, but that allows Matthew Justice to capitalize, drop kicking him down to the outside. Gets to his feet, this Wolf. Going to the well with that drop kick. Didn't help him out very much though. Back suplex here at ringside, and now Matthew Justice. Gonna try to continue to wear Wolf down. Picking him apart as much as he can. Up to a count of 5. 6. Matthew Justice using the ringside environment to inflict further damage. Josh Wolf, though, the absolute legend that he is after everything he's been through here in this matchup. Blowing a kiss to Matthew Justice. Very cheeky springboard crossbody, man. Splat goes Matthew Justice. Off the outside mat. And now Wolf, at long last, has himself an opportunity here. Thrown into the security wall. Runs into a pop-up sort of pseudo drop kick. Now it's Matthew Justice getting a taste of those steel steps. Another slap down across the chest. We are up to a count of 8. Matthew Justice throwing Josh Wolf into the corner, getting himself back into the ring. Perhaps gonna try to win by count out here. No, breaks the count, but Bob Luger has seen enough. Bob Luger has seen enough. Matthew Justice takes him out. That allows Wolf to come up from behind and throw him right into that steel post. 3. Wolf taking a step back, sizing each other up. 4. Matthew Justice not sure who he wants to go for here. Again, gut first into the steel steps. 5. 6. Both men getting back into the ring. Or at least Matthew Justice is. Josh Wolf still skeptical here. Playing games with Matthew Justice. Luger again gonna get involved. Belly to belly suplex, crushing Matthew Justice here at ringside. And Wolf gonna throw him back into the ring as he finally had enough. But wait a minute, Matthew Justice with the wherewithal makes the hot tag to the CMB Anarchy Champion. Immediately with a back body drop to Wolf. Slowly picks him up to his feet. Collar and elbow tie up. Choke bomb incoming. Countered though by Wolf into an arm drag. Another collar and elbow tie up. Vintage Bloody Justice with the twist of fate. Now it's Josh Wolf who's trying to get the hell out of this ring right now. Tag made to Jared Leon. Hot tag made to Bob Luger. The work ethic titan. The monster of the Justice family. Headbutt takes him down. Josh Wolf gonna try to run interference. Wolf saving his brother. And invert. Beautiful small package driver from the cardio maniac, and maybe, just maybe, that'll be enough to finally deliver the win to click here in this six-man tag team matchup. No, much to the surprise of Luger. Stomp down onto the face, and Luger with the lapel lock. Lapel lock cinched in. This is what he used at Point Break to tap out to 10. Will it be enough to tap out Jerry Leon here tonight? Wrenching and wrenching and wrenching. But Jared Leon refuses to tap. There's absolute chaos in that ring right now. Not too sure what the hell is going on. Luger hooks the leg. One. Oh, broken up at the count of two. Does not stop his attack. That's Bob Luger, as we see Matthew Justice stand on top of Josh Wolf here at ringside, making sure he doesn't get involved any further. But the choke now applied to Bob Luger here. Picked up into the air. Big boot from Xander Slate takes out Bloody Justice. Then able to save Bob Luger from the clutches of the Mastodon. Cravat suplex. Matthew Justice begging for the tag. Jared Leon gonna comply. Bob Luger waiting for him. Immediately nails him with a dragon suplex. And Jared Leon not getting away so easily. That wrestling takedown, and now the helicopter spin slapped to the back of the head. Nothing but disrespect from Bob Luger here in this matchup. Pinfall attempt. One, two, almost. Had this match won right there. Bob Luger knows it too. He tasted that victory. Tag now made to the OG Dirty Heel. See if he can tie things up here for Click. Matthew Justice looking for a bit of Rolling Thunder maybe. Powerbomb countered by Matthew Justice into a roll up. Jared Leon back in, as we see Bloody Justice running around the ringside area. Oh, single knee backbreaker into a bro kick. Jared Leon seeing stars right now. Slate making sure to not ease up, keep the pressure on. Samoan drop. Up to the top rope he goes, potentially looking for that Macho Man elbow drop to the heart. But does Jared Leon even have a heart, I guess is the question. Hooks the leg. Okay, lets it go. Now hooks the leg again. One. Broken up by Matthew Justice. Not too sure what that was all about. Stomp down onto the face. One more time. Jared Leon gonna roll out of the way, goes for a clothesline, blocked by Slate. Russian leg sweep rolls over into side control. Right hands cracking the jaw of Jared Leon and Slate. All the way up and back down again. Elevator ride. Crushing Jared Leon, but still not finished. Busting him open in the corner there. Jared Leon fights free, maybe again looking for that two-handed choke, but Slate able to escape as Matthew Justice here at ringside. Giving Bob Luger the work, that's for sure. Can't see what's going on in the ring, though. There we go. Oh, here's what's going on. Trips him up. STF, vintage Slate. STF applied, but broken up by Bloody Justice before there can be a tap. Hooks the leg anyhow. One. Two, three, and Click with the win. After a hard-hitting six-man tag team matchup to kick Octane episode number 5. Looks like Slate had that STF locked in just long enough to get the three count. I really thought the match was over early on after Jared Leon hit that pedigree on Josh Wolf, but no, man. Wolf very resilient in this matchup, and in the end, Click stands tall. Will what Bob Luger said ring true? Will Click take control of Octane on the road to Ascendance 10? And coming up next, my friend, got some singles act as Ugbjorn makes his first appearance here on Octane. Going one-on-one with the history maker, Amber Reed. First time we are seeing Amber Reed in action with the Full Ascent revamp, where she took that loss to Matthew Oxley. But over the last couple of weeks, Amber Reed is finally putting some wins together in the women's division. Now she's going to put her back into the men's division here. Huge opportunity, no doubt about it, for Ugbjorn, who has, for these last few weeks, picked up some wins, suffered losses on Ignition, but no doubt about it, has to look at the matchup as a huge opportunity to launch himself forward should he put down the former women's world champion, former undisputed world heavyweight champion. I'm sure Amber Reed, just like every other superstar here in CB, has her eyes set on being a part of that King of the Hill match at Absolution. Eight superstars, one opportunity to potentially headline the grand stage of them all, Ascendance 10. We have our second qualifier a little bit later on tonight, who will join Robert Cross. We will find out. But right now, Amber Reed just trying to keep her winning streak alive. Ugbjorn, one mean looking SOB, and once that bell rings, it's not just his looks you have to worry about. Has yet to truly prove himself just yet here in CMB, though. But as I mentioned before, a win against Amber Reed will instantaneously put this newcomer on the map. Amber Reed, after months and months and months of crippling losses, missing out on huge opportunities, is finally starting to turn things around for herself these last couple of weeks. Will the winning streak be left intact, though, after she runs headfirst into Ugbjorn here tonight? Amber Reed headlined last year's Ascendance. She wants to do it again. The biggest show in CMB history, Ascendance 10. Here we go. All eyes on Ugbjorn and Amber Reed. As Ugbjorn hopes to make a statement at Reed's expense, Reed just wanting to continue to pick up these wins. Bring herself back to the position she was in around this time last year. Reigning as Women's World Champion, Undisputed World Heavyweight Champion, walking into Ascendance 9 as the Queen of the Proverbial Mountain. Whoa, nice clothesline by Ugbjorn. Obviously enjoying a considerable size and strength advantage here against Amber Reed. Pulls her up into maybe a Samoan drop, but we're not going to find out as Amber Reed is able to escape. Some well-placed elbows to the eye of Ugbjorn. Combination, of course, Amber Reed known to be a lethal striker. And there is a wicked DDT to Ugbjorn. Now going to focus on the bicep. Stomping on the big man while he's down. Gets back up. Dragon Skidoo. Coming up next, guys, we've got some mixed tag team action as international champion Jay Young and Anna Nixon going to take on the team of our general manager of Octane, Madison Wright, and her significant other, let's just say, Jason Spade. But yes, you heard that correctly. Our general manager in action here tonight for the first time ever. She's had enough of Jay Young running his mouth about her. He's going to get her hands dirty. Tries for a headbutt, does Ugbjorn. Amber Reed rolling out of the way the very last second. All Ugbjorn's going to get is a face full of canvas, and there's a beautiful sleeper slam by the ace of CMV. Now connects with a hangman's neck breaker, slicks back the hair, running neck snap. Ugbjorn in all sorts of trouble right now. Ugbjorn's leg is just about as big as Amber Reed's entire body. Doesn't stop Amber Reed from pouncing right on top of him, though. Brutal elbows right across the forehead. Ugbjorn not out of the fight just yet. However, elbow to the midsection gives himself an opening. Single knee backbreaker one more time and yeeting Amber Reed off to the side like it ain't no thing but a chicken wing. Beats his chest. Reed just getting right back up to her feet like the absolute PIMP that she is. Walked over to the corner, introduced to that top turnbuckle. Amber Reed fights back with a punch to the chest, goes for a high kick. Ugbjorn able to duck under, connects with the high kick that time though. And another great combination. The A trigger coming out of nowhere, busting Ugbjorn open. One, two. Millisecond to spare. Ugbjorn keeps his head above the water, but perhaps not for long as Amber Reed. Oh, beautiful! Rolling thunder into the complete shot. One, two, three, and Amber Reed. Yet another win collected by the history maker here tonight. I did not expect the rolling thunder. Amber Reed stepping up her game lately, man. And Ugbjorn leaving the ring as just another victim here tonight. This is the Amber Reed we have been missing, man. This is the ace of CMV. This is the history maker. Now it's time, my fine feathered friends, for some tag team action as international champion Jay Young and Anna Nixon prepare to take on the team of our general manager, Madison Wright, and her, Facebook official? Are they boyfriend girlfriend? We're still not entirely sure, but as I mentioned before, significant other will stick to her now. Jason, who of course is not in the best mood after failing to capture the international championship from Jay Young at Point Break in that submissions count anywhere match. Jason Spade doesn't is over. Far from it, as a matter of fact, because they're tied. Jason Spade tapped out Jay Young at revamp. Jay Young tapped out Jason Spade at Point Break. Jason Spade, he will not stop until that international championship is his, and Jay Young respects him along with everyone else here on Octane. Seeing a new side of Jason Spade after that loss at Point Break. You might say snapped a little bit. Been getting flashbacks. Don't forget. Make Gumble come in here right now. But Madison Wright putting the next tag team match together after getting sick and tired of hearing Jay Young run his mouth past month about how she and Jason Spade's relationship is not exactly above board. Feels as though their relationship is the only reason Jason Spade got that national championship opportunity at Break, has been getting, you know, the spotlight, if you will, since the beginning of this season. And then sick and tired of Madison Wright getting in the way. Literally, a few weeks ago during that battle between Jay Young and Jason Spade, which allowed Spade in the end to stand tall over the international champion. Well, now Madison Wright gonna get her hands dirty, shut Jay Young's mouth personally here tonight. We respect our short kings here in CMC, all right? Maybe not Jay Young. I don't think he does. Sure, Jay Young was hoping that after his victory at Point Break, he'd get Jason Spade and Madison Wright, for that matter, off his back, but no such luck. Jason Spade does have a point. Jay Young and Jason Spade all tied up now. Young feels as though he definitively proved at Point Break who the better wrestler is, but Spade wagging his finger saying, not so fast. I'm not finished coming for that international championship, and you had better learn to put some respect on my name. Nixon sort of being tossed into the turmoil here tonight, but more than happy to get herself an appearance on Octane. Thus far, we've only seen her on Aftershock and Ignition, although I've been very impressed with her performance over these last few weeks. Although, if I were Anna Nixon, I'd be a bit hesitant here to lay hands on my general manager. Wouldn't want to get on the bad side of Madison right now. Jason Spade has made it very clear from the get-go that his relationship with Madison Rye has nothing to do with the opportunities that he's been given so far here this season. Been given those opportunities because he is Jason Spain. It's about time everyone here on Octane, including Jay Young, gives him the respect he deserves. Jay Young very fast to try and brush Spade off to the side after point breaks, and Spade letting him know this is far from over. I'm very interested to see how Madison Wright is going to fare in the ring. This is her first match ever. But Wright just getting sick and tired of hearing Jay Young run his mouth week after week about her. I can respect the general manager who gets her hands dirty. Here we go, mixed tag team action, of course. As we all know, the men fight the men, the women fight the women. So Jay Young and Jason Spade gonna kick things off here. And see Jay Young making a beeline for the international champion as that bell rings. Oh, high knee off the ropes, damn, and instantaneously Jay Young putting big time trouble at the hands of the Outlaw. Or the Outlaw no more, I suppose. Oh, response with his own kick to the face and an early tag to Anna Nixon. And here we go, our very first look at Madison Wright in that Octane ring, and well, not a spectacular start as she gets put down. With an exclamation point, that Hammerlock Spinebuster, Shining Wizard. We see that Anna Nixon isn't going to have any sort of qualms putting hands on Madison right here. Tag to Jay Young. Jason Spade more than happy to jump right back into the action. Madison Wright didn't even land a punch, I don't believe, there. So hopefully Jason Spade can keep this team above the water. Knee in the midsection, kick across the chest, elbow to the side of the head, kicks out the knee, knee to the jaw. You see that Jay Young is in La La Land. That second knee not going to help him out any. Kick to the knee and a kick to the chest, keeping Jay Young grounded as now Jason Spade starts to target the left leg. Nothing Jay Young can do here. Watch out, Madison Wright. Jason Spade in the zone right now, baby, and might be looking for that double boot stomp. No, instead waiting for Young to get up to his feet. Missile drop kick. Here we go, Madison Wright gonna get a second chance. See if she does any better this time. Nope, Madison Wright instantly taking advantage right into a German suplex. I mean, I don't know what I was expecting. This is Madison Wright's first match ever. She is in great shape though, and I'm sure that Spade has been training her. Kick to the gut, there we go. Look at this. Hurricane Rana out of the corner. Nicely done by our illustrious general manager. Now a drop kick to the shoulder. Kick to the middle of the back, keeping your offense very, very simple. Rolling neck snap. Jay Young not liking what he's seeing right now. Jason Spade brought back into the fray. Hey, this is a Christian family show. Up over the shoulders, Young gonna get tossed down onto Anna Nixon. Jason Spade taking out the trash. He's gotta be careful though. If he were to make direct contact with Anna Nixon, it would result in a disqualification. Great combo by the international champion. Standing C4. And now stomping on the knee of Spade, trying to take out his base. Not allow Spade to use that incredible speed of his. Tiger Driver right in front of the announce table. Madison Wright looking down at her flame, watching very closely as Young just dissects him, dropping him face first on the ring apron, busting him open. Can't really tell what's blood and what's face paint, though. Now it's Jay Young. Just tearing into the left leg of Jason Spade here. Up to a count of 10, having until 20 to get back into the ring. Jay Young going to save himself. Maybe looking to take the easy way out here tonight. Maybe not. No clean ring entry, though, for Spade. Jay Young right there. Spade ready for him, though. Trips him up. Double boot stomp. Now dragging Young away from the ropes towards the center of the ring. What the hell is Spade setting up for here? Oh, maybe the Collar City Clutch. Collar City Clutch locked in. Jason Spade gonna try to tap out Jay Young here tonight. Will he get a repeat of what we saw at Revamp? No, Young able to escape just as he did at Point Break. Jay Young not gonna give Spade the satisfaction, dropping him with a brain buster. And Jason Spade just gets right back up. That's gotta be pure instinct. Young dropping him with a forearm smash now. Look at how he goes right in front of Madison Wright. Looked like he was going to try to set up a super kick or something, but changed his mind. Another brain buster instead. And again, Jason Spade has no time for it. They're shooting here tonight, brother. Jay Young going to give it another go. Sizing up Jason Spade. Oh, maybe for that basement drop kick of his. Yes, but misses. Spade didn't even move. I think Jay Young just slipped on a banana peel. Tagged to Madison Wright, though. And Anna Nixon going to instantaneously greet her with a drop kick. Taken into the corner. Snake eyes for the general manager. No time to rest for Jay Young and Jason Spade. Excellent combination. Another standing C4, though, from the international champion. Frequent tags, in and out, in and out, in and out. Madison running at Anna Nixon. Beautiful clothesline takedown. Kick to the top of the head, though. Stuns her. Kick to the back of the knee. Oh, and a trouble in paradise, guys. Madison Wright's asleep. She's sleep, cuh. One, two, wow. I thought it was over right there for sure. Jay Young tagged back in. Jason Spade still sleeping on the outside, though. Jay Young gonna go and collect his foe, pulled up to a vertical base kick to the midsection. Pendulum backbreaker. And just rubbing Spade's bloody face into the outside ring mat. Elbow to the back of the head. You want to talk about no respect. That's all that Jason Spade wants from Jay Young and from the rest of the Octane roster. Respect. He wants to be acknowledged for exactly who he is. That's the greatest wrestler in CMB today. Nasty heel kick to the gut. Stomp down out of the ankle. Spade going for legs, but gets pushed back. Jay Young potentially going to try to... Oh, headbutt pulled up into a side suplex. Now, wait a minute. One, two. But Madison Wright saving the day. I believe that was over right there, man. I think the headbutt alone had Spade put to sleep, but the back suplex definitely, I think, was the nail in the coffin. Drop kick to the back of the head, moves out of the way. Does Madison Wright closing in on Nixon, gets a kick to the midsection, though. Sent into the corner. Slow, cautious approach. Maybe took a little bit too long. Collar elbow tie-up, Madison Wright. With a brain buster on the outside, we see Jay Young hit another back suplex. Madison with the upper hand right now. Approaching Nixon in the corner, got an elbow to the jaw though. Stuns her just long enough for Nixon to hit another German suplex. Oh, now it's Jason Spade with the upper hand here. Can't see what's going on in the ring, cameraman. Oh, cameraman. What's going on in the ring, though? There's a pinfall attempt. Nixon's got the leg hooked. And Anna Nixon, golly. 2.999. Not out of the woods just yet, though, is Madison Wright. Now Anna Nixon has a triangle choke locked in. What the hell is Jason Spade doing? I think he just distracted Anna Nixon, shouting at her from the apron. Good news for Madison Wright, who hits a perfect plex. I think a smart decision makes the tag. Squaring up, center of the ring. Jason Spade has no time for a third standing C4. Tying up that leg. Trying to use the middle rope to cut it in half. Another heel kick to the gut. Jae Young brought down onto one knee. His forearm smash puts him on his derriere. Madison Wright with those ninja-like reflexes to evade that that spinning kick there. Oh, and another Hurricanrana out of the corner. Nixon feeling the pain right now. Tag to Jason Spade. And walks right into the lands and burglopotomy, but Jae Young getting to know Jason Spade too well at this point. Look at that! Right into the Regal stretch! Regal stretch with Madison Wright for the second time in this matchup, guys. Saving Jason Spade, but the damage might be done, and Jae Young knows it. Only a two count, though. Tag to Anna Nixon. Madison Wright, the true MVP of this mixed tag team matchup. Oh, kick to the back of the head. Tripping Nixon up. Has herself an opening. She's going to take it. Madison Wright with a scoop slam. Goes up to Brett's rope. Beckoning for Anna Nixon to get up onto her feet. Madison Wright. Oh, man, going for some sort of maybe Hurricane Rana. I'm not too sure. Now it's Nixon waiting patiently for Madison Wright to get up to her feet. Dropkick missed it, though. Back and forth like a game of palm here between these two. I'll tell you this much. I am very impressed with Madison Wright in this mixed tag team matchup. But Anna Nixon is not impressed. As she again looks to put Madison Wright down, rolling on prettier, and that'll do it. One, two, three. Jae Young and Anna Nixon. You see Jason Spade at ringside, none too happy with the result. I still give Madison Wright the MVP award for this matchup, though. For her first match, went to war against Jae Young and Anna Nixon, but experience in the end awards these two with the victory. And coming up next, my friends, some singles action as Joseph Santos prepares to go one-on-one with the Ted. But for how much longer will the Ted be the Ted? As we know, called out by former Big Business a couple of weeks ago. And we found that out that a $100,000 ladder match between Big Money Inc. and evidence that inside the briefcase actually was not $100,000, but instead contract legally changing Big Business's name to Ted Business. And so Ted Business calling out the Ted for a steel cage match, the winner to keep the name the Ted. And the Ted responding, and once I'm finished with Click, Ted, too much Ted for me. Ted. Once I'm finished with Click, Ted, I'm coming. I accept your challenge for a steel cage matchup. I will prove I am the one and only the Ted. And, well, Ted is finished with Click now. Not finished in the way he would have liked to be, I'm sure, but steel cage matchup on the horizon. However, tonight, the Ted has got a big challenge in front of him, no doubt about it. Joseph Santos had a tear as of late. He's only has one loss on his career, and that was to Hugo Steele last week. But, of course, coming off of his incredible victory against Tito Val inside of a steel cage, nonetheless, at Point Break, one of the matches in CMB history. The bell rang, Joseph Santos hit the flatliner, and it was over. And now Santos saying he's moving on. He dealt with Tailcoat Val, put her in her place, for what anyone wants to think. And CMB is a better place for him. Now it's time to focus on himself. Well, the short and skinny of it is that the Ted has to defend his claim to being the Ted, as Ted Business is making it his business to be the Ted here in CMB. Does that simplify it for you? Joseph Santos has put Tailcoat Val and everything else behind him now. And even though the CM Universe is still a bit split on exactly how they feel about Joseph Santos, he says he doesn't care. The future is bright now that Tailcoat Val has been put out of her and everyone else's misery. Well, the Ted was the one who was tapping out at Point Break in that Anything Goes Tornado Tag Team matchup. Feels as though he might have a lot to prove here tonight. Try to get back on track with a win against Joseph Santos en route to that steel cage matchup. So here we go, Joseph Santos one-on-one with the Ted, but for how much longer will the Ted be the Ted? He might just end up being Ted. Joseph Santos gonna start hot here, sending Ted into the corner, throwing him down onto the middle rope, triangle dropkick by the Rat in the Hat. We've certainly seen a whole new fire in Joseph Santos this season. Like I said, what a tear he has been on. His only loss being to Hugo Steele last week, and what a great match that was. Going up to the top rope, Ted just now to his feet, caught with a hurricanrana. Ted gonna grab that leg, kick to the knee. Oh! Beautiful moonsault fall-away slam. And now center of the ring. Teddy boy gonna try for a submission, but Joseph Santos keeping him at bay. Jumping DDT. Springboard moonsault, but Ted nowhere to be found. instead of wicked knee to the nose. Santos just does not know how to stay down, though, for longer than a couple of seconds at a time. Modified single knee gutbuster by Santos. Has not given Ted a chance to breathe, man, since that bell rang. Oh, there you go. Fistful of canvas. Ducks the Ted's clothesline, though, and another jumping DDT. Now Ted in the mud right now. Santos hopping up to the top rope, maybe looking for that frog splash of his. Yes, he is. Good night, Teddy boy. One, two. Not so fast, though, says Ted. Doesn't want to follow up his loss at Point Break. Another loss here tonight. Able to get out of the way of that stomp. Big time knee to the eye. And a double leg drop to where the sun don't shine. Come on now. Below the belt. Loving this DDT here tonight is Joseph Santos. Third time he has hit it. Ted's had enough. Using the ropes to try and get right back up to his feet. I don't know if he wants to, though. Joseph Santos right there waiting for him. Blocks that. Oh, Ted Buster. Oh, wait a minute. We all know that sinister laugh, my friends. That is the laugh of the one and only Ted Business, but nowhere to be seen. That certainly is his laugh, but well, you can see Ted very confused right now. Turns around, Florida Flatliner. Santos went for the Florida Flatliner, but Ted blocked it. Ted able to somehow see that coming. Eyes in the back of his head. One, two. Oh, but only a two count. That is how crafty the Ted is, man. He knew exactly what Joseph Santos was going to try to do there. You don't play with the Ted like that. Santos was more than happy to try to capitalize on the interference, though. Oh, wait, the TED? What the? Countered by Santos into a power slam. That was awesome. Uh-oh, and now the Florida Flatliner connects. Good night, Ted. One, two. Maybe it ain't bedtime for the Ted. 2.999. And these fans chant and fight forever. They're loving what they're seeing right now here between these two. Ted still in the fight. I was going to say, man, Ted Business. He's a shockwave superstar. What business does he have coming here to Octane? But he didn't come here. Just paid someone in the production truck to play his music. He's got that disposable income, you know. Oh, forearm smash by Santos. Tip up, inverted atomic drop. If he gets the scoop slam, it'll be brought together very nicely. There it is, baby. Is it finally 9-9 time for the Ted? One, two. No, it is not. Ted's not tired here tonight, man. He's looking for an all-nighter. But Santos isn't. Follows that up with the vintage crucifix sit-out powerbomb. Santos gonna forcibly put the Ted to bed with a second Florida Flatliner. One, two, three. Joseph Santos picks up the win. And it seems like Ted Business is not all talk, baby. He came here tonight to throw Ted off his game, and it worked in the end. Joseph Santos elated to be picking up yet another victory. But Ted Business means business, baby. And the Ted had better not underestimate Ted Business, because Ted Business wants to be the Ted And if the Ted wants to remain the one and only Ted here in CMV, he's going to have to win that steel cage match. I really don't understand what's so confusing about it, you know? But here's a matchup I've been looking forward to all week long, my friends. Champion versus champion as Kate Stronghart gets set to go one-on-one with Io. And of course, Point Break was a great night for both of these young ladies. Kate Stronghart in front of her friends, in front of her family in her home country of Canada, retaining the Women's Hardcore Championship against Allie Cage. And meanwhile, Kyo doing the unthinkable, upsetting Ashley Rae in the finals of the Women's World Championship Tournament to become Women's World Champion. And Kyo even saying herself, even, you know, greater than that was the handshake from Ashley Rae afterwards. You know, the veteran giving Kyo her flowers, if you will, shaking her hand and then leaving her to celebrate a huge victory. But now Kyo is the Women's World Champion. We are officially on the road to Ascendance 10. Time to rest. No time to celebrate for very long. And she is straight in the deep end here tonight against the Women's Hardcore Champion, Kate Stronghart. And if this doesn't sell the show, you can be damn sure our main event will. So come Troy Colt one-on-one with the CMV Global Champion of Blade Virtue, first time ever here in CMB. So, of course, still have our King of the Hill qualifier, 8-man over the top row battle royale to come. Or too many or not enough? I think we need Ashley Mel back, to be honest. That's what we've been missing. I haven't called Ashley Rain Ashley Amell or Ashley Amell Ashley Rain, and it's been too long, you know? And there she is, still the CMV Women's Hardcore Champion, and Kate Stronghart, officially the longest reigning Women's Hardcore Champion in CMV history. She has successfully defended that title 3 times now. It's held it since towards the end of last season and doesn't seem like it's going anywhere anytime soon. But Kate Stronghart, much like Kyo, you know, as a champion, there's no time to rest. And after her victory, her retention against Allie Cage at Point Break, it was Ashley Riot who made it very clear she wants a shot at Kate Stronghart and that Women's Hardcore Championship. I know Stronghart would love nothing more than to walk into Ascendance 10 as the Women's Hardcore Champion still. And she has proven since she first stepped foot here in CMB, she's a fighter, man. She's not backed down from any challenge, including that triple threat match in CyberSlam. Here we go, our very first look at Kyo with the CMV Women's World Championship. Look at that, it's a beautiful sight. Who could have imagined, man, just a little over a month ago at Revamp when we saw Kyo for the very first time that she would be standing here today as the Women's World Champion. But the rookies in the end beat the vets. And it's a fresh face leading us into this new era here in CMV, leading us down the road to Ascendance 10. I don't think Kyo wants any rest, man. She's ready to jump straight into the deep end here. There we go. Champion versus champion. Cage Strongheart, Keio Strongheart with the victory here tonight, guys. Could see herself propelled into that number one contender's position. Of course, Keio needs a number one contender. Absolution just 4 weeks away. Who will Keio be making her first championship defense against? Cage Strongheart with a hot start. Tries for a vertical suplex as Keio drops down behind. Does no nonsense into a German suplex. Stomp now. Oh, right into a knee bar. Knee bar very quickly applied. The submission specialist wasted no time letting Keio know exactly who she's in that ring with. I don't know that Keio has faced anyone thus far in her CMB career as dangerous as Cage Strongheart. You know, Keio enjoys that faster pace. Great athleticism she brings to the table. Cage Strongheart, meanwhile, loves to slow things down. Loves to keep things going at her own pace. Big hook to the jaw by Keio. Forearm smash, knife edge chop, blocked by the women's hardcore champion. Now walked over to the corner, face first off that top turnbuckle. Forearm smash, kick to the midsection. Let's get things started in here, says Keio. Going after the knee of Strongheart. Kicks her right back into the corner. Knife edge chop. Woo! Lighting that chest up with the 4th of July, baby. Now it's time to stomp a mud hole. Golly, Keio. Oh, well, here comes Ashley Rain, guys, who Keio, of course, defeated at Point Break in the finals of the Women's World Championship Tournament. And afterwards, they shared a firm handshake, but it looks like maybe that was all for nothing. Roll up by Strongheart. Very nearly could have cost Keio there. Well, it seems as though Ashley Rain is making it very clear to Keio that she has not given up on her chase to become Women's World Champion. Keio with a rookie mistake, falling for that distraction, and it very, very nearly cost her this match. She was able to kick out of that roll-up, luckily, and now trying to get back in this match as Ashley Rain has gone to the back. Making her intentions very, very clear, though. I think a lot of people knew that there was something else behind that handshake at Point Break, though. Ashley Rain of old may have shared a handshake like that, but the new Ashley Rain, there's going to be strings attached. Keio just learned that real quick, but she's got to refocus. Tries to shake off them cobwebs. Now she's hesitant to get back into the ring, though. Cage Strongheart coming to track her down. Keio with a great combination. The combo queen of CMB. Cravat suplex. Stop, you're giving Bateman nightmares. Belly to belly suplex at ringside. Gonna crack the back of the women's hardcore champion. Keio going for a powerbomb? Keio! What the hell is she doing right now? Powerbomb onto the security wall! Good lord! Set up that appointment with the chiropractor real quick. Cage Strongheart. Tough gal, though, to be back up on her feet already. Back into the ring. Double wrist clutch, Northern Lights suplex. Goes up to the top rope. Could be looking for that diving headbutt of hers. Yes, she is. She's going for it. Oh, but Keio able to roll out of the way. Cage Strongheart may have just served herself up on a silver platter. Keio tries to capitalize. Strongheart going after the arm now. Trying to rip it right off, it looks like. Fixing to crank that neck, but Keio on her feet. Well-placed punch to the gut. All it takes is one and a kick to the gut. Clothesline. And again, catches the kick, flipping her up. Woo! Keio feeling it right now. The energy coursing through her veins. Able to counter Cave Strongheart's attempted kick to the side of the head. And then Tyler Hockey clothesline just like that, baby. 1-2. Man. 2.999. Keio thought she had it in the bag for sure. Even arguing with referee Johnson here. And that gives Cave Strongheart a chance to get back into this match. Drop kick to the knee. Back up to the top. Cave Strongheart gonna give it another go. The leg drop. Oh, mama. 1-2. Cave Strongheart a bit miffed, a bit astonished at the fact, but wait a minute. She's in position, going for the sharpshooter. Keio knew it though, she sensed it coming. Going for the Tanahashi clothesline again. Again! She just keeps going for it. Cage Strongheart excellently able to counter though. Dragon Screw! What a matchup this has turned out to be here between these two. Very lucky it didn't end off that roll up. Keio slowly brought it to her feet as Cage Strongheart says enough with the diving. Headbutt, let's go for the Owen style pile driver instead. 1-2. But Keio still not finished. Neither is Cage Strongheart, unfortunately. And no nonsense this time. Gonna get the sharpshooter locked in. Nice and tight. Nowhere to go. Will Keio tap or can she? No, taps out. And Cage Strongheart with a massive dub here tonight on Octane. And there you see Ashley Rain getting involved in the matchup, distracting Keio, nearly costing her this matchup. And Keio tried as she might, man, to get back into this matchup. Even nearly had the match won right there after the Tanahashi clothesline. Just could not. Against Cage Strongheart. Hitting that Owen style pile driver and then the sharpshooter. Game over for our new women's world champion. I'm sure not the way she wanted to get her reign started. But Cage Strongheart taking no prisoners, man, on the road to Ascendance 10. To our cheery main event we go, lads and gents, here on Octane episode number 5, and it is time for our King of the Hill qualifier of the night, 8-man over the top rope battle royal. We're going to find out who will join Robert Cross, who of course qualified earlier this week on for that King of the Hill match in 4 weeks time at and one. The biggest show in CMB history for a shot at any championship the victor oh so desires. And again, Robert Cross punching his ticket earlier this week. Shockwave, we'll find out who takes another spot here tonight. Kwame Bullitt, Cam Harris, Ozakai, Hugo Steele, Amare Rivers, Cousin Chase, Fidel De La Rosa, or Adam Valentine. Well, obviously, we've got a lot of beef in this matchup here. As Brad would so eloquently put it We got some hogs about to slap in that ring right now. You got the Ozakai, Cousin Chase, and Hugo Steele, who alone might be might win more than the rest of the competitors combined. And still tonight, guys, our co-main event, see Gianna Di Natale in action, one-on-one with Riley Van Wilson. And in our main event, Troy Colt, Blake Virtue, one-on-one, non-title match, first time ever here in CMV. As a potential banger, a certified slapper. And I bet you any money this fucking game left is on, even though I turned it off. And of course, this will be an 8-man over-the-top rope battle royale, which means no pinfalls, no submissions, no countouts, no disqualifications. The only way to eliminate someone is to throw them over the top rope. Both their feet must hit the outside of the ring. Last man standing goes to Absolution to partake in the King of the Hill match. And here's a man who very much would love nothing more than an opportunity to headline Ascendance 10 after failing to capture the CMB Global Championship at Point Break in front of his friends, his family, his home country of Canada. What a match he had against Blake Virtue, but unfortunately coming up short in the end. Kwame Bullitt feels as though he is destined to make it to the main event of Ascendance 10. Guys, what does that mean, bro? What exactly do you mean by that? You beat guys. Well, his theme music says it all, my friends. Cam Harris is looking to hit the jackpot here tonight and punch his ticket to the King of the Hill match at Absolution. You know, Cam Harris has accomplished a hell of a lot in his CMB career. Former Rising Star champion, former NGW world champion, former Zero G champion, former international champion. Feels as though it's high time he becomes world champion. And he has quite a bone to pick with Blake Virtue. Cam Harris has been calling Virtue out for a long time now. Yeah, well, certainly if you're a betting man, you'd have to put your money on the 500-plus pound Ozakai. There's going to be one tough SOB to get over that top rope, but the same can be said about this man, the former Zero-G champion, the Bull, Hugo Steele, who, of course, last year, Ascendance 9 fought Joseph Santos in that steel cage match for the Zero-G Championship. How about Ascendance 10? He headlines for a shot at any championship he oh so desires. This is going to be a big, beefy boy battle, no doubt about it. Hopefully the ring is reinforced. I'm going to be over a ton weight-wise in that ring. And here comes the biggest threat, quite literally, in this battle royal. The 500-plus pound Ozakai, who of course made a living in Japan as a sumo wrestler. Where if you don't know, if you've been living under a rock, in sumo you have to throw your opponent out of bounds, out of the ring in order to win. So this literally is the Ozakai's perfect scenario here. Ozakai, though, been having a lot of troubles as of late with one of his opponents here tonight in this King of the Hill qualifier, Cousin Chase, who's gotten a victory not once but twice over the Ozakai. And making his official in-ring debut here tonight on Octane, episode number 5, the man who cost Fidel De La Rosa the CMB Anarchy Championship at Point Break, Amare Rivers. And we're still not really clear on exactly why he did that. Amare Rivers only going so far as to say, I want to keep the Justice family happy. And whatever I have to do that, I will do. And that includes screwing over Fidel De La Rosa at Point Break. Fidel swearing vengeance after what happened to Mario Rivers, responding saying, "Fidel, don't make a foolish mistake. This is fate. This was destined to happen. You can't mess with fate. And if you try, you're gonna regret it." Well, Amare Rivers and Fidel De La Rosa bolt in this matchup, but hopefully Fidel can focus on the bigger picture here. That's punching his ticket to absolution and not let his emotions get the better of him. Easier said than done, though, of course. And here comes the undefeated Cousin Chase, baby. Recently getting his second victory against the Ozakai. Will Cousin Chase take this undefeated streak all the way to absolution? Imagine Cousin Chase headlining Ascendance 10. That would be a sight to see. And Fidel De La Rosa, I'm sure, not 100% after what he went through at Point Break. Physically, but mentally, not 100% focused either, especially with Amare Rivers being in this match. But if Fidel De La Rosa wants to take a step in the right direction towards potentially, oh, he still got the CMB Anarchy Championship. So that's where, I guess he stole it after all. He found out where Bloody Justice was keeping it backstage. Fidel's not ready to give it up, man. He feels as though he was robbed. Feels as though that championship was stolen from him. Where's Tracy James's true Anarchy Championship? We need to give that to Fidel De La Rosa. What a slap in the face to Bloody Justice. Fidel coming out here with the Anarchy Championship. Last but most certainly not least, round out this King of the Hill qualifying matchup, the fan favorite, no doubt about it. The self-proclaimed GOAT of CMB, Adam Valentine, has hit a bit of a rough patch these last few weeks. Not been so great for Valentine. Losing to Troy Colt, of course, at Point Break, and that loss to Click and Tag Team Action, the other loss to Troy Colt. Adam Valentine desperate to turn things around, and what better way to do that than to win this qualifying match? Here we go. King of the Hill qualifying match. Eight man over the top rope battle royal. Who's going to join Robert Trost? And six others still to be determined. Greatest opportunity on the line. A chance to headline Ascendance 10. Adam Valentine showing no fear as he goes right after the Ozekai. Meanwhile, Kwame Bullitt and Amare Rivers there in the left side corner. Fidel De La Rosa and Cam Harris middle of the ring. Cousin Chase and Hugo Steele here. Lower left corner. Only way to be eliminated is to get tossed over the top rope with both your feet hitting the outside. No pinfalls, no submissions. Continues until there's one man left standing. Robert Cross, I'm sure, watching this matchup as he will watch every other qualifier to see who's gonna. And the Ozekai is the first one eliminated. Adam Valentine, man, crafty, pulling down the top rope as the Ozekai charged at him. How about that quick thinking? And the odds-on favorite is the first one eliminated. Ozekai gonna hit the showers as we are down to seven. I'm pretty sure everyone else is very thankful about that. Very thankful they don't have to deal with the Ozekai here. Kwame Bullitt rolling up on the Sin City Savior with a shin breaker. R.A. Rivers, very tall, very strong, but as we saw at Point Break, incredibly athletic as well. Adam Valentine just talking here, giving a little speech mid-match. Zero miedo, says Fidel De La Rosa. Zero fear here. Cam Harris in jeopardy at the hands of Kwame Bullitt. Cheeky jab. Hugo Steele drop Cousin Chase face first on that top turnbuckle. Fidel De La Rosa so far able to keep his emotions in check, hasn't even looked at Amare Rivers if you ask me. Good idea, because Amare Rivers though, no, gonna take out Fidel and then mock him. So not only does Amare Rivers cost Fidel De La Rosa the Anarchy Championship, but now costing him a chance to potentially headline Ascendance 10. And right after that, guy's Cousin Chase also eliminated by Hugo Steele. And Fidel De La Rosa has to be fuming right now, man. Amare Rivers costing him two opportunities in just 1 week. Sour, sour luck for Fidel as Adam Valentine tells everyone to suck it. Hook to the jaw, Hugo Steele. Nice trip up STO. My Bullitt, not too sure who he wants to go for here. Super kick from Amare. Takes out Destiny's Firstborn. Discus form smash from Adam Valentine only pisses off Hugo Steele. Gonna make him pay with a power bomb, but Valentine able to escape. Clothesline backing Hugo Steele up against the ropes. Hugo just gonna throw him down. And now Amare Rivers sent packing by Cam Harris. And then there were four. Cam Harris, Hugo Steele, Kwame Bullitt, and Adam Valentine, one of these four men, gonna punch their ticket to Absolution in the King of the Hill match. Kwame walking Hugo up against the ropes, takes a step back. This could end very badly, and it nearly does, but luckily Kwame Bullitt not eliminated. Hugo now just gonna dare someone to step up, and Cam Harris dares. Adam Valentine gets thrown out on the apron, hooked to the jaw, and Adam Valentine has been eliminated. Kwame Bullitt almost eliminating himself as well. And that tugs at the heartstrings of the CMB Universe. Adam Valentine, no doubt the fan favorite here, but he has been eliminated. Hugo Steele now back into the corner by Cam Harris. The big man teetering. Kwame Bullitt more than happy to just sit back and chill out. Watch from afar. Right for his opening, his opportunity. Tornado and Zaguri takes out Hugo Steele as Kwame Bullitt beats his chest right in Cam's face. Discus, ya bunchet! Off the fireman's carry. Kwame Bullitt, will it be Cam Harris or will it be Hugo Steele? It makes their way to Absolution to partake in the King of the Hill match, join Robert Cross and six others. Hugo Steele just having himself a great time right now. Cam Harris walking right into that pop-up German suplex. Kwame Bullitt's having himself a little bit of a nap here. Cheeky jab, knife edge chop. Hugo Steele getting backed up against the rope. Super kick. Now goes for Kwame. Hurricanrana. Ooh, and a couple of right hands as well. Closer and closer. Hugo Steele gets those ropes. Uh-oh. That big meaty claw wrapped around Cam's throat. Choke slam. Lays out the Sin City Savior. Hugo Steele going for a drop kick. Not where Hugo wants to be. Cam Harris gonna try to take him out again. Look at that, so big though. Oh, Hugo, holy shit. Kwame gonna come and help out. Cam Harris and Kwame Bullitt together. Can they eliminate Hugo Steele? They are trying. This is a big boy though. Hugo Steele hanging on for dear life. But no, somehow stays in this match. Nah, nobody's sure who they want to go for. Looks like maybe Cam Harris and Kwame Bullitt going to continue to work together here. Oh, spoke too soon. Finger of Cam Harris. Hey, if you don't have any fingers, you can't hang out of the ropes. Not a bad strategy. Now Kwame finds himself potentially in trouble of being eliminated. Battles back Cam Harris. Quick fisherman suplex. Hugo Steele very, very slowly at his own pace, picking himself up. Puts down Hugo Steele. Another tornado in Zaguri. None of these three guys, man, willing to go down without a fight. But Hugo Steele potentially finally having enough of Cam Harris, but Cam Harris just continues to fight. Laying underneath that bottom rope. Excellent strategy. Remember, you got to be thrown over the top rope in order to be eliminated. Exactly what Cam Harris is going to try to do here. And look at this. Harris and Bullitt again with some teamwork. Double Russian leg sweep to Hugo Steele. Well, man, just doesn't know how to be friends, though. German suplex instantly puts down Harris. Now sent into the corner. Elbow to the jaw, though. Hugo Steele rolling up on him as well. Trying to break through Kwame's defenses with these open palm strikes. Oh, what the hell is going on? What the fuck? Not too sure what was going on there. Hugo Steele gets blasted with the knee to the jaw, though. Know that much. Another discus punch off the fireman's carry. Dropkick right to the back of Kwame's head, gonna put him down. Absolution awaiting one of these three men, and it might not, no! Kwame, wow, what a save. What a save. Jumping knee, gonna lay him out in the center of the ring. Cam Harris, loving this discus punch. Kwame Bullitt, not so much, gonna finally counter it on the third attempt. Hugo Steele gets back to his feet, instantly panders to these fans in the front row. Schoolboy super kick. Hugo Steele reeling right now. Cam Harris makes things even worse with a discus forearm smash. Hugo, oh, using that face mask as a weapon. Headbutting Cam Harris. Butterfly suplex. Throw him into the corner. Saying, where you going, mofo? Crawl away from me. Oh, another choke slam from the deepest depths of hell. Kwame trying to get between these two. Maybe not such a good idea. You will see it right back up after that dragon screw. And an old school pile driver. Smash from Cam Harris. Kwame Bullitt with a roar. Cam Harris trying to walk Hugo Steele over to the ropes, man. The final three turning into a half hour classic here. Nobody getting eliminated. Another super kick off the schoolboy. Oh, look how tired Kwame is, man. That punch he threw was so weak. He is exhausted right now, understandably so. Not falling for that a second time. Kwame able to wise up. Fisherman suplex. Hugo Steele doing a whole lot of just laying around. The last 5 minutes or so, spending the vast majority just underneath that bottom rope hanging out. Now Kwame Bullitt busted open. Headbutt again lays out Cam. Inverted atomic drop. Big boot. And here comes the senton. Bring it all together nicely. Another roar let out by Kwame Bullitt. So he's going to get some of the same. Oh, or maybe not. Wrestling takedown, the helicopter spin. Really want to disrespect someone like Hugo Steele, though. The perfect battle royal maneuver, the wrist clutch assault. Cam Harris checking to make sure his boots are on nice and tight. Right to Kwame's face, man. That ain't gonna happen if Kwame Bola has something to say about it. Putting him down. Oh, stomp to the back of the head. Cam Harris seeing stars right now, and Kwame Bullitt yeets him out of the ring. Cam Harris eliminated. It is down to this, my friends. Hugo Steele, Kwame Bullitt, who is going to Absolution, who's going to be a part of the King of the Hill match. Will it be Kwame Bullitt? Destiny's firstborn. He's trying to get the big man over the top. Oh, but no such luck. Punch to the gut, dropping to the knee, lays out Hugo Steele. Biting that hand. Oh, here we go. Need to wear down Hugo Steele a little bit more.
Thank you.
his back on the fingers. Glides off the kidneys. No time to take things nice and slow right now, though. Hugo Steele realizing that. He's got to get Hugo over that top rope, man, sooner rather than later. Not too sure if he wants to take out the base of Hugo Steele here. Then he's got to lug around 300 plus pounds. Kwame Bullitt. Kwame, man, he had it. He had it. Hugo Steele. Not so easily put out. Wow! Holy shit, he almost threw him right out of the ring. Knee to the gut. Hugo Steele with a suplex toss. These two have got to be exhausted at this point, man. We started with eight, we're down to two. Who is going to Absolution? Who is going to the King of the Hill match? Punch to the gut, gonna take all the air to Kwame Bullitt! Bull splash! Bull splash flattens Kwame. All he's gotta do now is throw him over the top, baby, and that's exactly what he's gonna do. Kwame trying to hang on with whatever he has left, but there's nothing left! Hugo Steele is going to the King of the Hill match. That final three was wild, man. Nobody wanted to give it up, but the bull splash in the end, dispatching of Kwame Bullitt. Easily thrown over by Hugo Steele. And so Hugo Steele joins Robert Cross and six others in 4 weeks' time at Absolution. That protective mask, not a whole lot of protection. Still bleeding with that mask. And it is now time, my fine feathered friends, for our main event of the evening. Of course, coming our main event, Troy battles Blake Virtue for the first time ever here in CMV. But first, Gianna Di Natale going to take on Riley Van Wilson. Very much looking forward to this one. Two submission specialists. Going to find out who is the better here tonight. And of course, for Riley Van Wilson, really hoping that tonight is a turning point thus far here in the new season. Taking a lot of losses. She was really hoping after everything that happened towards the end of last season with Xiao Rong, you know, was put behind her and moving on to bigger and better things. But instead, she's just really not been able to get going. Meanwhile, Gianna Di Natale has been red hot ever since we first saw her at Revamp. Of course, she did fail to make it to the finals of the Women's World Championship Tournament, defeated by Ashley Rain in the semifinals. But now wanting to bounce back by defeating a former Women's World Champion. Perhaps keep herself towards the top of the rankings. Will this indeed be a chance for Riley Van Wilson to start going in the right direction here on the road to Ascendance Town? You know, interestingly enough, Xiaorong has been having the very same problem here in the new season, man. She just cannot get a win. It's loss after loss after loss. Seems like as much as the two wanted to put the pass behind them and move on, it's easier said than done. Here we go, Gianna Di Natale, Riley Van Wilson, two lethal submission specialists. Referee rings the bell and instantaneously calling a bow tie up center of the ring. Riley Van Wilson takes an early lead with some great strikes. Here we go. This is what we've been wanting to see from Riley Van Wilson as of late. That fire. I'm waiting for the Polish warrior to come out and play. Italy versus Poland here. My goodness! Riley Van Wilson lighting Gianna Di Natale out in the 4th of July! Even beating the hell out of her on the top rope. Good Lord Almighty. I don't think Gianna Di Natale was expecting that. Here we go, though. Now able to fire back. Irish Whip throws her down to the outside of the ring. Hesitant at first to take this fight to ringside, but impatient as the Venice Beach Vixen gets nailed in the midsection with an elbow, hooked to the jaw. God damn, these two beating the hell out of each other, and a hammerlock spinebuster at ringside. Definitely doing some big time damage to that arm, and Gianna Di Natale knows it as well, grabbing the arm. Picking Riley Van Wilson apart. Bends back on the wrist. Standing moonsault incoming. Gianna Di Natale letting everyone know she ain't no one trick pony. Not just those submissions you gotta watch out for. Dangerous striker, too. Great athleticism as well. Look at Riley Van Wilson with some big-time disrespect to the rookie. Natale going to make her regret that. Irish Whip putting her out onto the apron. Forearm smash. What the hell is she doing here? Oh, maybe the tenantula? A half of a tenantula? Finishing with a big boot to the side of RVW's head. Takes this fight back down to ringside. Double boots to the chest, gonna push her back. Using the apron as a weapon, Gianna Di Natale. Back into the ring at the count of three. Now she's mocking RVW. A little bit of a whoa! Oh, catching with a clothesline. She was getting back into the ring. Not just one, but two. And a falling drop kick. Gianna Di Natale feeling herself right now. Things going very well for her. Another standing moonsault. Riley Van Wilson helped up to her feet by Gianna just to put her right back down with that back suplex. And a third standing moonsault. If it ain't broke, don't fix it, as they say. Just like that, Riley Van Wilson finds herself in big time trouble. Gianna going for a kick to the gut, caught by Wilson, now hooked to the jaw, turns her around, seatbelt suplex, dropping Gianna on her head. Looks like she might be down for the count, but Riley Van Wilson, not satisfied, picks her back up, wrenching the arm. You know, Riley Van Wilson always on the hunt for that cross arm bar of hers. You can see that's what she's setting up for here. Goes for a pin. It's a two count, close two count though. RVW now knowing that Gianna Di Natale's hurt and goes for the arm, looking for the cross arm bar, but Natale able to fend her off. Not for long. Butterfly suplex. Stomps to the face, wrenching the neck, elbow to the gut. Gonna have her hunched over in agony. Oh, Natale fires off with that step up kick to the face. One, two. And Natale, just like that, man. The blink of an eye. Could have had this match won, very nearly did have this match won. And the fans certainly loving what they're seeing. Fight Forever chant. This has been nothing short of a slugfest since that bell rang. And Natale now knowing that she's in the driver's seat taking her time. This standing moonsault just does not fail. That's why Natale keeps going for it. Those ribs of RVW gotta be feeling like a fine powder at this point. That kick to the midsection is not gonna help. Oh, Natale! Oh, I thought maybe she was under that satellite DDT of hers. Holly Van Wilson. Not a lot of fight left, but whatever fight is left, she is bringing to the table here. This losing streak really catching up with her. Something that she's got to be thinking about constantly. Oh, here's that satellite DDT I was talking about. Dropped on her dome. And that's got to be it. One, two, three. Gianna Di Natale secures the win against Riley Van Wilson. A big win for the Venice Beach Vixen. And the losing streak continues for the Polish Warrior. What has to change for Riley Van Wilson? Whatever it is, needs to happen sooner rather than later. And now, last and just, it is time for main event evening here, Octane episode 5. Troy Cole prepares to go one-on-one with Blake Virtue. non-title matchup, but Troy Colt, knowing very well that a win here tonight make him number one contender, especially after against Adam Valentine at Point Break. Many already consider him to be number one contender, but this would make it official. Troy Colt pining for a chance to become a global champion here on the road to Ascend 10. Virtue fresh off of what many consider an upset at Point Break, defeating Quiet Bullet in front of his friends, his family, in his home country. Oh, Canada. Against those odds, Blake Virtue emerged CMV global champion and determined to walk into Ascendance 10 global champion. Eve the same. The Colt, though, has other plans. His plans include getting that global championship Absolution in 4 weeks. The best way to make that a reality is to put down Virtue right here tonight in our. These two have known each other for a very long time, but this is the first time they're ever facing off in a CMV ring. Troy Colt's never been hotter. Blake Virtue's never been more ready. Colt knows that this might be the biggest match of his CMV career to date. In fact, no doubt it is. Not even blinging. Blinging. He is blinging. Troy Colt is always blinging, but not even bringing his protege, Chloe Marks, down to ringside for this matchup. He needs to maintain 100% focus. No distractions for Troy Colt here tonight. Great many people in the CM universe did not expect to see Blake Virtue coming out here tonight with the CMV Global Championship still around his waist. But he proved every single doubter wrong at Point Break. Never have the odds so severely been stacked against Blake Virtue. And still, he somehow emerged as CMV Global Champion. Virtue prepared to jump right back into the deep end here tonight. So here we go, Troy Colt, more than ready. Blake Virtue is, though, too. Potential show stealer for our main event. Card number tie does not last long as Blake Virtue throws Troy Colt right into referee Johnson. And rolling up on him from behind with a straight jacket German suplex. Will Troy Colt see himself become number one contender here tonight with a win? Wicked knee to the face. And another one. Keep Troy Colt down. Virtue coming for the pin, not a minute into this matchup, trying to make quick work, trying to embarrass Troy Colt here, which is pretty surprising. 3 minutes and 30 seconds means a lot to Troy Colt. And Troy Colt is a much different person, though, than that man who was beat in 3 minutes and 30 seconds only a few months ago. Evolved has Troy Colt in that time to a main event player, a credible threat to Blake Virtue and the CMV Global Championship. Proved that. Did Troy Colt beyond a shadow of a doubt at Point Break with this victory against Adam Valentine. Well, it's been all Blake Virtue since this match began. Now look at this, another Fisherman's Driver. Colt just blindsided as soon as that bell rang, and Virtue whooping him from pillar to post. Oh, knocks him down to the outside with an enziguri now. Not even gonna give Colt a chance to catch his breath either. Stays right on top of him. Colt able to finally fire off a shot. Northern Lights suplex rolls through into the brainbuster. Troy Colt's incredible upper body strength on display there. Gets a kick to the midsection. Troy Colt says, enough of the Fisherman's Drivers, brother. Another Northern Lights suplex instead, going to save his skin. Five. Up to a count of five. Troy Colt, not the kind of guy that wants to win by countout disqualification, most certainly in this type of scenario. He wants to pin Blake Virtue here tonight. Clean as a whistle. Prove to everyone that he deserves to be number one contender. Prove to Blake Virtue, most of all, misses that knee drop. DDT off kneeling position. Here we go. Colt starts to get going. Keeping Blake Virtue off his feet with a hangman's neck breaker. Let Virtue start to zip around that ring. You are going to regret it, and Troy Colt knows that. Knee drop of his connecting. And the detonation kick, but maybe took just a tad bit too long setting it up. Colt with some elbows, able to save himself. But there we go with a T-bone suplex. Up to Brett's rope goes Troy Colt. The best moonsault ever. One, two. Troy Colt felt how close he was right there. Now going up to the top rope. Maybe looking for a super, no! The Phoenix Splash, but Blake Virtue got to his feet just in the nick of time. And there's the step up knee to the face. Hooks the leg. One, two. Blake Virtue can't believe it. Saying, come on now, Johnson, that was a three count. I know that was a three count. But Johnson saying, no, this match continues, but perhaps not for much longer. 360 Codebreaker, he missed it. Troy Colt stepping back just a bit. Enziguri, he did not get all of it, but got enough of it. Double leg drop to the nether region. Snaps the knee. Back up to the top rope. Troy Colt going to try again for the Phoenix Splash. No. Instead, waiting for Virtue to get up onto his feet. Meteora! Double knees to the face, rocking Blake Virtue. Troy Colt coming at him with a hammer fist. Walks him over the ropes, drops sternum first. Now it's Blake Virtue who wants to permanently ground Troy Colt in this match with some shots to the knee, pushed back though by Colt. Pops up to his feet with the quickness, helping Blake Virtue. What a nice guy. This corner is not where Blake Virtue wants to be when against someone like Troy Colt, and here's why! Troy Colt! Wait a minute, he knows it's gonna take something massive to put down Blake Virtue! Avalanche 330 slam! Hooks the leg! One, two! But Blake Virtue kicks out of the Avalanche 330 slam. Oh, but Troy Colt saying, I ain't having any of that, brother. The Phoenix Splash gonna follow it up. And surely, that will be enough. But no, Colt's not satisfied. He wants to hammer that final nail in. The 330 slam, but got a bit overzealous to Colt. Now he's gonna pay for it. Virtue able to counter the 330 slam. Back and forth now, man. You can feel the tension. Knee to the midsection, sucking the air right up out of Colt. Responds with a dragon screw. Running off the ropes. Knee drop right to the mouth, that looked like. Standing moon moonsault connects. Anaconda Vice! Anaconda Vice! Vintage Troy Coltis, he applies the Anaconda Vice here! And could he potentially force Blake Virgin to tap out? What a win that would be. But Colt unable to get a submission out of Blake Virtue. Resorts to the side headlock headstand. Having some fun at the expense of Blake Virtue, but no time for antics here. Troy Colt knows that as he goes back on the attack. Elbow to the jaw. The 360 Codebreaker connects in the second attempt. One, two. What? Yeah, the look on Blake Virtue's face says it all, my friends. He is astonished. How the hell did Troy Colt kick out of the 360 facebreaker? These fans chanting fight forever. Oh, this match has certainly lived up to the hype so far. But the time for talk is over. Fisherman's neck breaker. After the step-up knee, misses the knee drop, though. This could be Colt's last opportunity to get back into this match, and he knows it, too. What great defense by Virtue, man. Blocking those punches and those kicks. Escapes the fireman's carry. Does Colt right into a Falcon Arrow. Virtue just pure instinct, man. Tries to get right back up to his feet. Tries to remain in the fight. Kick to the top of the head, rocking Troy Colt. And that's all the opening. Blake Virtue needs another 360 facebreaker. One, two, three. Blake Virtue victorious. What a match from bell to bell. Troy Colt holding his own against Blake Virtue. But in the end, the CMB Global Champion battles back another would-be contender, and we see Virtue offer some respect to Troy Colt for a great match, and Colt going to accept, of course. Like I said, these two go way back, and I certainly hope this isn't the last time we see them go one-on-one.